There are many small things we learn in the Bhagavad, you know, that like I learned today in the Bhagavad, experiential learning. Watch out, after you hit Kotopuram, be careful whether you're turning towards Nandanam or Alvarpet. That's the lesson I learned today. Okay? So we have to, if possible, try to find out what the Deputy Chief Minister's schedule is, so that you can avoid that route depending on where you want to go. Okay? Of course, the safer option is to take a very long route, come via Mount Road completely. Get out of IIT, go via Sardar Patel Road, hit Mount Road, and take Mount Road right up to the point you want to turn off towards Poonamalli High Road. So that's the route I can take. Hopefully Mount Road will not be blocked, you know. Because very often blocking Mount Road means has voting implications. So okay, so that's the way it is. So informal learning, experiential. But why do we need both? This is very important. I'll give you a classic case. You cannot learn swimming from a book. It's not possible. Yes, I can learn about the principles of swimming from a book. It's not a, that's absolutely easy. I can easily teach about buoyancy theory, drag theory, etc. from a book and say this is what happens when a person swims. But how do I learn swimming from a book? You can't. I have to get wet if I want to learn swimming. That is experiential learning. Similarly, it's very difficult to compose music through only concepts. You know, you need a lot of, through only experience, I'm sorry. You cannot compose music only through experience. You have a standing example. I'm a fairly good guitarist. I'm a fairly good rock and blues singer. But I have given concert, public concert, with big names also, okay? But I know what my weakness. I don't know the theory of music. And what is it? So experientially I'm all right, but conceptually I'm almost zero. And this is an important point we have to convey to teachers, students and parents. Without conceptual learning, you actually don't get freedom. It's a very important point I'm making to you today. And the truth is, true freedom actually comes from structure and not the absence of structure. This is a phenomenal truth in India. If you want freedom, freedom comes from structure. I may be talking philosophy, but actually it's grounded philosophy. If I want to compose music, I must know the theory of music to compose music. Otherwise, the best I can do is I can compose a tune. I cannot compose for an orchestra. Please understand the difference between compose. I can do even right now, I can compose a tune at will. Okay, that's a tune, so what? You know? But sir, I'm not sure every one of us can compose a tune. But I want to orchestrate the tune. And there is a purpose for orchestration. What is the purpose? You are trying to influence the mind of the listener. So every composer wants to create certain moods while listening to music. I mean, you know when you are listening to a song, chinna chinna aasai, siragattam, whatever it is. So you want to create a mood in the person. And you can't create that without understanding the theory of music. It's very difficult. So you need the conceptual foundations for bringing about experiences. So the two are absolutely interconnected. And this is why we keep bugging teachers in engineering. You cannot say, I'll teach only theory, I'll teach you differential equations, matrix algebra, heat transfer theory, momentum transfer theory, combustion theory, etc. That's all right. But unless the guy runs an IC engine and actually studies what happens, in terms of combustion and power transfer, there is no way that guy is going to understand the IC engine. It's like learning swimming from a book. It'd be as stupid as that. Okay? And similarly, this is the point I made, so that you are convinced of creating the right balance between conceptual and experiential learning. Please connect, sir. I told you, conceptual learning and formal learning are very happily married in the school and higher education system in India. Experiential learning and formal learning are boyfriend-girlfriend. They're not happily married yet. Okay? You got the idea. Experiential learning, informal learning, very happily married. Conceptual, informal learning, boyfriend-girlfriend. So you got the concept now. So there's something we have to do. There's an intervention that we have to do. We means the leaders in the education system have to intervene. That's what I'm trying to say. How do we intervene? How do we bring this to practice? How do we see to it that experiential learning also takes place through the formal system? It's a challenge. And how do we see toward the informal learning takes place through conceptual, through conceptual learning. So, how do we, I'm not talking, please don't immediately mistake me for one of those Hindi or Tamil or Telugu serials where we talk of illicit relationships and nothing but that in every serial.